Today we're going to discuss ozone vaginal insufflations. If you want more information on ozone, check out our Basics of Ozone Therapy video linked in the description below. For this video, we're going to assume you already know about ozone. Vaginal insufflations are a method of delivering ozone to the body at a safe concentration through the vagina. These are a great way to provide ozone systemically into the body. The vaginal wall has the ability to absorb ozone into the bloodstream and lymph system, making it an ideal combination option. There are two ways to do vaginal insufflations, and we're going to go over both of them. After that, we'll go over how to perform these insufflations. The first method is the easiest. You'll need a high purity oxygen source, an ozone generator, an insufflation bag, and a vaginal applicator. You will fill the bag up with ozone, attach it to a catheter or vaginal insufflation device, and then administer the ozone. This is fast and easy. The second method is a little more complicated but can provide added benefits. You'll need an oxygen source, ozone generator, a water bubbler humidifier combo, some extra tubing and connectors, and a vaginal applicator. With this method, ozone runs from the ozone generator into the humidifier and then into the applicator of your choice. The advantages of this method is that the ozone flow is constant and the humidifier moistens the ozone so it's less drying. Using this method, some are able to insufflate more frequently and for longer periods of time. Now I'll describe how to perform the first method. Hook up your oxygen source to your ozone generator. If you have questions about this, you can check out our set of videos linked in the description. Once the oxygen is hooked up, you'll set the flow rate. A good rate for filling an insufflation bag is 1/4 liter per minute. Once it's flowing, you will turn on the ozone generator, setting your ozone dials to the right number to get around 30 gamma. For example, with our O3 Elite single, with your oxygen set to 1/4, you will set the ozone dial to 7. Consult the gamma chart that came with your machine to see which numbers will work for you. It is important to use an ozone generator that can be adjusted directly on the machine for greater flexibility, as ozone can be irritating and uncomfortable if the gamma is too high. Once your ozone is set, attach the insufflation bag directly to the ozone generator. Make sure the clamp on the bag is open. Fill the bag to the amount of ozone you want to use, from 200 to 750 milliliters. A good starting point is 200 milliliters. Make sure you don't overinflate the bag. Once you have the right amount of ozone in the bag, unscrew the bag from the ozone generator. Clamp the tubing on the bag to close it. Turn off the ozone generator, then turn off your oxygen. Attach your insufflation applicator to the bag. Before inserting, lubricate the applicator with a good natural lubricant. All natural plant oil is good for this. It is recommended that you lie down on your back and to put a towel underneath you to catch any discharge. Not everyone will experience this. Insert the device 3 to 5 inches and slowly roll the bag to deliver the ozone. Go as slowly as you need. When the gas exits the applicator, it will travel down the vaginal canal and exit. It is not a concern if the gas does not exit evenly. Once you have emptied the desired amount of ozone, remove the applicator and detach the bag. You'll want to wash or dispose of the applicator. If you wash it, use soapy water, hydrogen peroxide, and then rinse with water. Check out the end of this video for what you can expect after an insufflation and more information on how often to perform them. Now we'll go over the second method. Once again, you'll want to hook up your oxygen to your ozone generator. A setup video is linked in the description if needed. After hooking up the oxygen, you will attach the ozone humidifier. We recommend the water bubbler humidifier combo because of the included filter system. For information on how to set this up, you can check out the video linked in the description. You will need some extra silicone tubing, and you'll want to make sure the humidifier will be close enough for the tubing to reach you. Use distilled water with your humidifier and make sure the diffusing stone is fully covered. Turn on your oxygen source to 1/16 or 1/8 liters per minute. Set your ozone generator to achieve around 30 gamma. Use the ozone concentration chart that came with your generator to find the right settings for this output. If you're using the O3 Elite single and your oxygen flow is 1/16, you'll set the generator to 1. If your flow is 1/8, you'll set the generator to 3. You should now see ozone bubbling in the humidifier. Make sure the filter system on the bubbler is set to filter the ozone. Wait 10 minutes for the water to saturate with ozone. Once that's done, attach the extra piece of tubing to the exit port on the destruct filter and attach a male lure lock fitting to the other end of the tubing if one is not already installed. Attach the applicator to this fitting. You can lubricate the applicator with some natural plant oil. Lie on your back on a towel and insert the applicator 3 to 5 inches. Turn the switch on the filter system so ozone flows through the applicator. Because you are using a humidifier, you can insufflate 5 to 15 minutes depending on your level of experience and your needs. When you're done, flip the switch on the filter to turn off the flow, then turn off your ozone generator. After that, you can turn off the oxygen. Wash or dispose of the applicator. If you wash it, use soapy water and hydrogen peroxide and then rinse with water. After an insufflation, you may experience some gas pressure which will slowly diminish. For some users, you may experience spotting for up to several days. This is normal. It is recommended to perform vaginal insufflations every third day. If you do it too much, you may experience irritation. If you do, discontinue use or consult your healthcare practitioner. If you like this video or would like more information on ozone, visit our videos page or our YouTube channel. Subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell to be informed when we upload new videos. For more information on PromoLife's ozone therapy generators, glassware, and accessories, visit www.promolife.com.